Greetings, everyone, and welcome back to Java for Beginners. I'm joined by Ed Burns, who's going to talk to us about JShell. Ed, do you want to introduce yourself and tell us a little bit about our topic today?
Thanks, Brian. I'm really excited to be in the Java for Beginners series, and especially talking about JShell, which is a technology that's really great for beginners because it strips out all of the other noise that you don't have to worry about with Java and lets you focus just on the code. It's even more lean than the leanest IDE you can possibly imagine. It's a read, evaluate, print loop for Java. It has full access to all of the classes that you would load and unload, being able to access the class loader in a command line fashion in a shell environment. So for developers that are just coming to Java, it's a great way to just copy paste code in, type it in, edit the code, and see what it does. So it's a very good beginner's tool.
In this brief video, we're going to talk about JShell, the shell for Java. It's a command line tool, and it's a part of the JDK. If you have Java 9 or newer, you already have it installed. It's useful because it's a command line read, evaluate, print loop for Java. Think the approachability of basic programming with the power of Java. This means it's a really great tool for exploring new language features. There's no compilation step, no build process, no Maven or Ant. You can really just get in and get things started very quickly. It was developed like everything else in core Java with community governance and transparency. If you want to see the original Java enhancement process request, you can follow this link here and in the description below. Everything done in the core JDK is done with this JEP process. Everything done in Java EE is done with the JCP process. A 5-minute video like this is not intended to teach everything there is to know about anything, but JShell himself has very excellent context-aware in-product help. If you want to look for the definitive guide, you can follow the documentation below. Let's start it up. Here's a pro tip. We are using -v printing arguments. -v is for verbose feedback. Printing is a shorthand to cause JShell to import the most common language features related to printing on the console. Let's take a look at that context-sensitive help that I mentioned earlier. Everything you type in JShell is treated as a snippet of Java, except if you start with a slash. If you start with a slash, you're talking to the JShell interpreter. These are called slash commands, and it's a tip of the hat to the late 90s IRC text chat tool, or as us olds like to call it, Slack without emojis. Here's another pro tip. There is full tab completion. Pressing the tab key will cause the possible valid inputs, given the current context, to be presented, prompting you to choose the right one. Let's talk about some foundation concepts. Aside from slash commands, everything input into JShell is a snippet. There are three kinds of snippets. Generally, you don't need the closing semicolon. JShell can usually tell when one is required and automatically add it. A snippet is either an expression, a statement, or a declaration. Declarations can be either non-nested, that is, top-level declarations that stand on their own, or nested, that is, declarations that make sense within other declarations. I'll explain each one of these now. Let's type an expression. 2 plus 2 is an expression. When you type an expression, JShell will assign a scratch variable to it, so you can refer to it later. You can see all of the currently known variables by doing slash vars. You can see we have an assigned $22 to the expression we just typed, 2 plus 2. Let's talk about statements. A statement is a Java statement, just like what you'd expect. So hello world is a statement. You can say print hello world. Or if we're coming from a C background, we might say printf %s with an exclamation point, hello world. And it will give us the same output with the exclamation point there. Those are statements. Let's talk about declarations. In Java, you declare something like a class so you can use it later. The complete list of declarations in Java is import, method, class, field, and interface. First, let's review nested versus non-nested declarations. There are some rules for non-nested declarations, which you can read here. Generally, these special rules don't get in the way, but they are necessary to allow JShell to do its job, where you're basically typing in your statements at the top level of the Java state. So let's do an import. The first kind of declaration is an import. We're going to import scanner, Java util scanner. If you do slash imports, you can see all of the imports that we have currently in the state. The ones I've shown above are imported by either the dash printing or dash v printing or the default load up startup ones. That's imports. Let's talk about methods. Here's a simple method declaration. This is a loan calculator. These sample methods and classes are part of Java champion and educator Ken Fogel's Java in Education resources. The link to these and other classes is in the description below. So let's go ahead and paste that in and declare created method loan. We can invoke the method just like we would in Java by doing a parentheses after the method name. We'll type in the term, the interest rate, and the amount of the loan. And we see that our monthly payment is $94.36. If you'd like to see the method, you can do slash list, and all of the things that we've typed in so far will be printed out. You can also do slash methods and see the methods that we can call, including the ones that were defined by dash printing. That's methods. We can put this same method inside of a class. So here we have the same thing, but it is inside of a class, and we call the loan method from the main of that class. So we're going to declare the class right there, paste it in, or you could type it if you like. And now that it says created class Java Calculator 01, you can do dash types or slash types rather and see that we have defined a new class there. Let us invoke the loan method via the main method. And we're just going to say new Java Calculator.main. And we're passing the string array we need for the main method. So we get prompted for the same set of values as before. The next type of declaration is a field. Now, fields can be defined at the top level, non-nested, or of course, as member variables or static variables inside of a class. Now we can see we've got I as the one that we've defined, and also the implicit one that we did with 2 plus 2 earlier. And that's fields. Let's take a look at interfaces. We will define a new interface that we can slap onto our existing loan calculator class. So we'll define an interface called banker, which has a method called loan, which is a coincidence since we've already defined loan. So let us define the interface. If we do types, we can see we have interface banker and class Java Calculator 01. If we do list, we can see the class does not implement the interface. See, there's no implements there. So how can we fix that? Well, we can modify the state. And this is one of the really impressive things about JShell. All of the state is completely mutable. So we're going to edit our class using tab completion there. And we can see because I've specified the editor value of Emacs, it loads up Emacs and loads the class there. And we're going to just specify implements banker and save the file. And if we do slash list again, we will see that it now implements banker. That's the intro to JShell. Stay tuned for the second part where I show a practical application of interacting with a Java EE plain old Java object using JShell.
Thanks for watching. Please take a look at the resources for JShell in the show notes and enjoy many of the other episodes we have in the Java for Beginners series.
Thank you, Ed.